You are listening to 4625 kilohertz, UVB 76, the buzzer. Please stand by.
Wait, what? This thing's on? Oh. Greetings, buzzer listeners. You're tuned in to the buzzer overnight. To avoid dead air, we have partnered with the following gift from the United States. The PAA podcast is recommended for mature audiences. Oh, what is it about introing that show that marks one losing me? Toodaloo. Time to go. Drop the kids
off. That's disgusting.
Cool, if you know what I'm saying.
This crap needs to stop.
You are listening to the PAA podcast. Juggalo Patriot.
Operators are standing by.
I told you it's a long ass intro, man.
Shit, how long is it? I thought
don't worry
something
about it.
Broken.
Nah, it's done. All right, here we go. All right.
That was so...
What is up, Daves? It's Saturday, and you know what that means. Oh, fuck me. Yeah, it's Saturday, you know what that means. You're watching the number one conservative podcast in Nevada. We are not a free speech organization. Check us out on Rumble, bitch, you Odyssey. Well, shit, hang on. Let me check this Twitter thing real quick. This is a brand new era.
What are we doing? We're learning.
All right. I got no notification. I have to do it through the app. So let's find out. I got I'm getting texts from
your
people.
Mobile app.
Through the mobile app. So let me see if that doesn't cause a huge problem.
Twitter's a place to be again.
Apparently, yeah. So let's hop into my space, start now. Now I gotta take one earphone off or something. So I can hear this shit.
Mm-hmm.
And that's if anybody jumps in here. Like, all right, well, it's recording.
They'll start talking. Yeah.
Fuck it. So, yeah. We'll see if anybody. All right.
You're like the moderator.
So if you're listening on Twitter, you jump in on Twitter. The real place to be is paalive.us. That'll get you into this Zoom meeting right here. And if you're not down for that, go to Facebook. And then we'll see you in the comments. That's where the stream is going out. Speaking of which, I screwed up and didn't load up an image for this. Hopefully it works correctly, but God, is the show even going? Let's see. All right, it says it's live. There we go. I'm always fucking something up on here. Let's see. Yeah, well, I managed to go live. Fuck it.
Fuck it. We'll do it live.
Yeah, I was scrambling. Somebody was using the studio right before me, and I was like a freaking out. So now, I don't know if I can leave this. I got to leave this Twitter app to see if I can. We'll see how that works. Whatever. It's not a priority. I just wanted to try it out. I tweeted out, this is the 100th episode, as far as I can tell.
The 100th PAA episode.
Correct. Yeah. There's missing stuff. There's missing episodes. Let me go back to the notes. Did I miss anything? Yeah, a couple of things I got to get through real quick. But yeah, this is a huge deal. So hopefully there'll be some people joining us to join in, because you know the campaign stuff is getting close now,
hot
right?
And heavy.
Yeah. So
hot and heavy.
Do you want to risk not being exposed to all the audiences, former chairs and trustees of the Clark County Republican Party and their audience, or do you want to go without that kind of exposure? Because now's the time. PAALive.us. Just jump in here and get real.
we'll get to the nitty gritty of who you are as a candidate.
Yeah, I tweeted out to a bunch of candidates, so I mean we can cold call some of them. I might get you to look up their phone numbers.
Have you done this before?
I have cold called a candidate before. Sitlali Larios.
They answered.
She answered, yeah. And I told her we were recording her. Me and Rob were recording her. And then I started asking her. It was before filing. So I was asking her why she was running. And, you know, that she shouldn't run. And I was right, of course. But, you know, it was rude.
It's pretty.
And I wouldn't say that to somebody now because filing is passed. So, you know, it's time to knuckle down.
You probably shouldn't have filed.
No, we're not looking yeah. back. We're running forwards. Like, what are you doing? So, yeah, I want to call some of these candidates. Now, Sitlali got upset because, and I would always love it if I got cold called by newspapers. Hey, Chris, yeah. You got a minute? I got 5. I got 10. What do you need? Yeah. You know what I mean?
What
like,
you got?
Yeah.
That was a weird feeling, right? All of a sudden, these people are calling you because you wrote your name down somewhere.
Yeah, and a phone number. Yeah.
Yeah. It was always weird. You always wanted to be prompt with it, right? Like,
they want to know about
my campaign, but you know, they usually twist it in a negative way or depending on, you got to figure out which media person you're talking to, how to talk to them.
But even a rando would call you sometimes. But I mean, you know, like,
yeah, but what I've determined with any media, even the best, they have an agenda, right? Like they have a script they're trying to write.
Right.
They're just looking for your right words to put into their script.
Gotcha.
And they give these certain questions because they want you to say certain words. So, it, you know, you got to be careful as a candidate not to be trapped by even the friendliest of news reporter. They're usually the worst. They'll come back and they'll just be like, yeah, like bitch in the ass. Well, for every word that you said to him.
That's the good thing about this thing, though, is that, like, this can't be taken out of context. I mean, unless I completely, like, just didn't upload an episode, which would be weird. Uh-huh. I'm going to find a... I think there's something wrong. I didn't share this correctly. It's okay.
On Facebook?
Yep. Did you see it pop up?
I saw an alert pop up.
Yeah, it did pop up. Okay. All right, well... Fuck it all. It's asking me to insert an image, and I didn't upload the current thumbnail. Really need a producer.
Oh, you made one?
Oh, I always make one. I made it ahead of time. You didn't see it?
Mm-mm.
Oh, it's fun.
No, I don't have Facebook open.
Oh,
I'll open it.
Fuck it. So, I got a couple of things to promote. Let me pull those up. I always got to promote these things. Let's see. First of all, this is somebody from the Podcast Producers Guild. Thanks to the Podcast Producers Guild. I now have to play this.
Stop hating! Stop! Stop that shit now! I love everybody! I love everybody! I love you!
Where'd you go?
Stop hating!
Did I lose you?
Can you not see me?
Could you hear me?
No, I hear you saying, where'd you go?
Yeah, I couldn't hear you for a moment.
Yeah, I was doing something in OBS. I played the stop hating thing. You're going to catch everything a little late on Facebook. I don't know how we can make that work. You can't see what I'm playing in the production stuff.
Well, I can't watch Facebook. That's too confusing to watch myself.
I hear you.
In the past.
Yeah.
It's like it's too confusing to even look at.
I got you. So, yeah, there's something about me being a hater and something about crabs. Did not share the
soundboard last week.
You did hear me playing that last time, right? Let me see. Share screen. Yeah. Yeah, share sound is on there. I don't know. I can't share the thing. So you didn't hear this.
Stop hating! Stop! Stop that shit now!
No.
Weird. Producer.
Weird. Huh.
Here it looks like a little squirt sound.
It goes through my thing. All right. So, then I got to play this, and you're not going to hear this either. But it's a party. It's 100 episodes, and Sherman... he sang us a little song, Sherman. Yeah. Sherman Ray.
That's a great song.
Yeah, I don't have the music part because I don't want to get pulled. Yeah, I don't want to get pulled. But the little ditty that he made up while he was just doing his show.
He's not roasting coffee.
Yeah, not yet. Oh, he is roasting coffee. But this one was about the show. Here we go.
Booze flowing, people laughing, chit chat, fun, fun, fun. Booze flowing, people laughing, chit chat, fun, fun, fun.
Booze flowing, people laughing, chit chat, fun, fun, fun.
Fun, that's what... fun, fun.
Hey, and that's not even edited. That's just looped. I love it.
Oh my gosh.
Oh man, he is the best. You know something.
See the number two or number three podcast.
Well, he's not a conservative podcaster anymore. He's a podcaster who is conservative. He does a magazine called Living in Vegas and also Living Weekly, based off of a song that he did back when he was with the Supremes or whatever the fuck. You know, one of them.
What?
He was with one of those, you know, the bands that had like.
He's a singer?
You didn't know?
He's like a. No.
Okay, listen. my numbers might be off a little bit, all right? And the names might be a little bit wrong, but there's this dude named Gunther. He had a fucking band, Four Seasons, fucking Doodly Pops, whatever the fuck, you know? And gotcha. him and the dudes broke...
60s.
Sure. And him and the dudes broke up, right? And the Doodly Pops all fucking branched off. There was one lady Doodly Pop in there, too. So what you basically ended up with is like fucking superhero factions that then, you know, were able to form the West Coast Avengers, the East Coast Avengers, the West Coast Doodly Pops, Garl, Gunther's, Gunther Gable, whatever the fuck. Sherman is one of 147 or 174, I get the numbers mixed up, members of that band that are in the Las Vegas.
174 members in a band?
It rotated a lot of people through there over the years, my friend. As long as it goes to this day, dude, is still members, but only up to a certain point. They got inducted into the Las Vegas Entertainers Hall of Fame. Sherman Ray is in that window. He is in the Las Vegas Entertainers Hall of Fame. So you got to respect that.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Wow.
You didn't know that?
So he does he do like a lounge act on the weekend somewhere?
Fuck no, dude. No, he don't sing no more, man.
I mean, if you're in the Hall of Fame for singing, you should, like, this is the town to make money.
Yeah, but you got to maintain and you know, he probably, his voice probably ain't exactly what it used to be. It's a lot of coffee drinking I don't think he really rides that bike as much as he says. He probably can't like really belt him out the way he used to. You know, he's like, I don't know, 60. I don't know how old he is, but I'm just saying. Yeah, I bet he can still. I bet in the car he's a pleasure to be with when he's singing. He doesn't do it on his show, which kind of sucks. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But
it may be one of those draws that brings people up, in.
Speaking of which, since we're riding the Sherm train, let me fucking hit this promo. If people want to advertise on Sherman's show, apparently I'm obligated to do this too.
Oh, the producers.
Hi everybody, this is Sherman Ray for Living in Vegas podcast.
Yeah.
Are you a business owner that's looking to get the word out about his great business, is he trimmed product, this? Or service? Well, nothing could be simpler.
He took out the part where he...
Hi, everybody. It's Sherman Ray.
Up to where he restarted.
Podcast. Are you a business owner that's looking to get the word out?
He just left in all that product, random service? Bullshit.
What is that? Like a piece of styrofoam?
I don't know. There's like a reflector, I think, that is catching the corner of the camera over here, right? Something like that, or over here. And then there's a fucking like janky palm tree in the background.
It's like...
And it's a practical... palm tree, like it's some sort of fucking like crazy blue light, and then what the fuck, dude? Like, why would I pay money for? And here's the thing, dude, people do pay money. I think I've actually got a meeting coming up. I know I hate when people hate when I burp on the show, but whatever. I'm drinking because there's booze flowing
and fun.
Got to get some of these candidates to call in here. Let me see if anybody popped up on the Twitter. Absolutely,
so we had a candidate retweet earlier.
Sharelle Mendenhall has retweeted several of the tweets. Send her a link right now.
Who's running her account?
You don't think it's her?
Let's figure it out.
Or the old man?
You know, she's kind of a big-time candidate. She's probably got a media manager.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. Tweet her right now. PAALive.us. Hey, anybody out there watching, no Sharelle, just hit the link and tell her. All right, let me find a fucking picture that's just blank so that I can... Did it post a picture when I gave it to you? Here, fuck it.
Gave it to me where?
Never mind. On Facebook. Facebook's fucking acting up. When you got notified of the thing. Fuck was that? All right. Let me tweet at her. Let me see. I'll just make a long ass tweet. All right. What should I say? Are you motherfuckers pussies?
No.
Are y'all scared? No, I'm kidding.
No, we have serious questions.
Serious questions about EMPs. The Chinese. Here we go.
My truck is protected from Chinese EMPs.
Real talk. Let's talk. Real talk. Chinese... EMPs.
So you don't know what candidate you want to call first. Huh?
I'm gonna hit them all up on Twitter first, and then we'll look up some of their phone numbers and just start calling.
Yeah, just call it a candidate call-in show.
The shitty thing is, if they don't, I need to text them. That's when you do text them PAALive.us on that number, because yeah. that's the fucking problem is I want them here on the Zoom so I can see the their face, talk to them. So somebody doesn't say I got an imitator or some shit, you know what I mean?
All right. Yeah, yeah. There's a lot of those out there.
Dude, I do pre-production and like pre-record some shit from a candidate. I don't fuck around, you know what I mean? I did a whole video. My dad did a whole video, you know, as fucking a singer, the Greasy Dean thing. They got no fucking traction. Don't think I won't waste my time fucking.
It got censored is what happened.
It got
shadow banned and censored.
Fucking, yep. That's what we always say. When nobody watches our shit anymore. It's because I'm a conservative. Oh, man. It's because I'm doing a fucking, what's that shit when I lived in New York? What the fuck was that shit called? Public Access TV. Do you have that shit in Kentucky?
Mm.
I didn't have it in Virginia.
Yeah, yeah.
You had it?
Yeah.
We didn't get it until later in life, but man, when I moved to New York, Public Access TV was crazy. That's what this is. You do whatever the fuck. Yeah. Except, you know, nobody else's airtime.
I mean, it's Wayne's World.
Exactly. Yeah.
It's what Wayne's World was, yeah.
Chinese EMPs, what else? And green screen them in Delaware and shit, right?
Twitter, Elon Twitter.
Elon. There you go, Elon. I should be hashtagging these, but fuck it. Should I hashtag
China?
It? Nah, fuck it.
Yeah.
Nah, dude, hashtags don't mean shit.
Shanghai, China.
I already said Chinese EMPs, Shanghai?
No, it was Shanghai, yeah. That's where we got 26 million. You want 26 group? Million people locked up.
Okay. Shanghai lockdown? How about that? Yeah. Shanghai.
I wonder if is there a hashtag?
Oh, shit. I don't spell Shanghai lockdown. I don't know. I just type it in, and then I've noticed that it comes up if you look for a hashtag or a search. It'll bring up Shanghai lockdown.
What was Shanghai? It used to be called something else, right?
Yes, but I don't recall. Peking? Maybe.
Was it Peking?
Probably. You probably should Google that. We're going to get flagged for misinformation.
Oh, shit. Yeah, by the Chinese censors.
Yeah, hang on. We got that.
It's kind of like Istanbul was once Constantinople.
Yeah, now it's Constantinople.
Shanghai was once speaking.
Yeah. But nobody was it. Nobody really something but the Turks. Shit. I can't remember. What is that? They might be giants? Yes. Yes, sure. It is. The answer is yes. Hey, yeah, we got time. Let's get some of these fools on.
Beijing, no, Peking.
Nice.
Peking.
We got people that are on super secret restriction watching. Here, let me bust through some of these notes real quick. We need a trustee spelling bee. Right. We should have a trustee spelling bee. Anybody running for school board, trustee spelling bee. Yeah, send out more tweets while I'm doing this. Jesse's been doing an election integrity school. Oh, no, he's got an election integrity school coming up next week on Saturday at 6 p.m. Huh, weird.
Second one.
It'll be the second one?
I think he had one this week.
I think so, too. Yeah. And that's a good thing. Let's see. Yeah, it's the 100th episode. Got that. Oh, he also has the Constitution show on Thursday nights. So he's a busy guy. You can catch those at the county headquarters. Oh, Nevada Republican Club rules. Rudy Pemintuan is the head of that sucker, and he's awesome. And I hope I can go to the they're having a Family Feud type thing one evening this week coming up. I haven't bought a ticket for that yet. I just got my ticket for the Nevada Republican convention coming up. And that was $100.
It's on the 30th, right?
Yeah, I think so.
100? I can't go. What happened? They used to be $45. Right? $45 and we'd have,
It's a state convention. It's in Las Vegas. You got a whole bunch of noobs coming in. It's time to squeeze those motherfuckers. All these candidates. There's seven candidates in every race. No, and everyone is going to want a table. Hey. I had a really good suggestion. Listen, I had a really good suggestion for clubs and organizations. Charge for tables what the registration charge is for their office. So assembly people, $100 a table. Governors, $350, whatever, $500, whatever it is.
Yeah.
And it's fair, you know, because lower level campaigns can, you know, get a campaign because you would expect the funding to be around on the same equivalent level. So,
And they should happily support the party.
Oh, no, for tables. Absolutely. Yeah. Yes. That is the one thing the party has is space. So yeah, giving it away for free is stupid. Yeah. Allowing people to commit crimes on it is stupid too.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a bad idea. It's a bad idea.
Yeah, you rent it to people for a very, very specific thing. So yeah, 100 episodes. I'm trying to shoot an ad. I want to do an ad in the desert. It's looking pretty good so far. Just did a little. I did it with a shirt on that saw through the green screen. So I got to fire. You know, I got to redo it.
Get a different shirt.
Oh, have you noticed some candidate signs getting trashed? I noticed Sharelle was actually talking about this. Oh, okay, really? Here. Yeah, sign vandalism. Here, now I'll tag it. Sign vandalism. And then I'm gonna put some, I forgot about the tweet. All right, so yeah, Sherelle's been saying that somebody's been vandalizing her signs, and I've been noticing there's a dude in AD 13 who's also been getting, misspelled vandalism. There we go, thank God for Grammarly.
Yeah, ours got shredded.
Dude, somebody
took
used
a
to
knife
be,
to ours.
Somebody was flipping Dan Rodimer's too. It was crazy. Like yeah, he
I mean,
had.
It's usually not political. You always assume it's like your opponent, but it's just it's some kids.
Yeah.
It's some kids, or you know, there's about a 10% chance it's your opponent that's doing it to those signs, unless it says something like about your political messaging or your like political nickname.
Yeah.
That shows that it's political. It's mostly just kids being like assholes, like they always are.
Should we do let's do Seagal as well.
The candidates will actually steal the rebar. That's when you know it's a candidate.
Yeah.
Because that rebar is expensive. A candidate will tear your sign up and they take the rebar for themselves.
Take the frame apart and leave the
then use it for their own sign.
Right. Dude, Rodimer was using metal like house framing or building framing like you'd use for a warehouse. It was crazy.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. All right. I tagged Joey Gilbert, Sharelle Mendenhall, Seagal Chittah, Jane Addams. That should do for now. They're all kind of like, yeah, all right. I'm going to tweet it. Oh, I gotta put the fucking link. Let's go. PAA live.us. Now. There we go. Boom.
All right, so who are you cold calling?
I don't know. Let me look somebody up. Let's see.
I guess. Start from the bottom.
Oh. I wanted to say this, Nevada Republican Club. If you go to Nevada Republican Club luncheons, if I get to go to one, if I have a Monday off and I get to go to one, I do not want to see. Here's what I want to see from candidates. One of your pamphlets on the table, on each table, one of yours at each,
one.
On each table so that we can look at it, pass it around, because guess what? We're all candidates. And I don't need your shit all around me while I'm trying to eat. So... You know, fucking relax with the papers.
You end up with like a pie. You end up with like a whole, like, oh yeah.
It's fucked. You can't even see the table. Yeah. It's embarrassing. And then they don't pick their shit up when they leave. It's terrible. Yeah. All right, let's see. Clark County filed candidates. Like, yeah, I would set a rule if I, and I know Rudy watches this, so he probably sees it, but I would set a rule. No, maybe one or two per table so that we can pass it around and look at it, but.
The club should add it to the table. Like the club should lay it out. The you know, you don't bring any in, we'll put yours out how we're gonna put it out. So it doesn't look like a, you know, Christmas party with all the wrapping around.
Right. But I mean we want to do is look at
it's
it.
It's conservative for the candidates, yeah.
Just wanna look at it and shit on it. You know what I mean? Like, look at this guy, he's got suspenders. Look at that tie. Why is this tie so fucking long? Look at his haircut. He's got his kids in it. You know, at the table, meanwhile he's like sitting to your left, you're like, oh shit. It's nice. Nice family. Very nice.
It's never happened to me before.
Where you're like, fuck this asshole. And then you look and you're like, shit.
No, because candidates never look like their picture either.
Right.
So it's like the candidate could be sitting right next to you and you look at the picture. It doesn't even resemble them because it's all buffed up and photoshopped. And you look like, I guess this is the same person.
All right. God damn it. I don't want to call somebody on the phone. See, Jane's the first one, and I tweeted at her.
Uh-huh.
I mean, I could text her, right? Like, if I had her number in my phone, right?
Ow.
What was that?
Cramp. Foot cramp.
Oh, shit.
You got a foot cramp. You know those ones that just won't go away?
Yeah.
Ah. I'm going to have to call time out. Holy shit.
Oh, man, deal with it right here on the air, man. You're an old man.
Fighting it. Fuck it. I'll do it live.
Yeah. Speaking of which, I'm an old man. This week, I'm going to be turning 50. Isn't that crazy?
Dude. 50.
50. That's something. You know what's fucked up? When I was 48, I was 48. And then the day I turned 49, I started saying I'm almost 50. I never fucking felt comfortable saying I'm 49. So, I don't know. It's a dodgy ass number.
Almost 50.
Almost 50. You know what I mean? Stop fighting it, fucker. You're there. So, yeah.
You're sitting right on top of it.
David Brog. So, there's Jane Addams running in C1, CD1. Uh-huh. Here, let me share this screen, and then we can pick one, and maybe the audience can pick one if there is an audience. Let's see.
We should get like a wheel.
I know, right? Like a
spin the wheel, and then we talk about that candidate.
Or just randomize it. Or we try and invite them in. Like I could text one of these phone numbers, but then they'd have my fucking phone number. Ugh. You got a spoofer that throws in.
How are you gonna call them and not have your phone number? Mm-hmm. You doing Star 67? Does that shit still work?
Yeah, I don't even know. Dude, is that on your end or my end? Is somebody running the fucking garbage disposal in the studio next door?
It's not on my end.
What the fuck? Jesus Christ. Listen. When I think
it's getting filtered out.
I hope so, man, because I'm hearing it in my headphones. When something in the studio's next door is popping off, like sometimes there's this Italian family that records a fucking show for some reason. They scream at each other. Or there's some gaming channel going on in one of the studios. Get wrecked. You know, all this shit. Or a fucking disposal. I guess there's a kitchen I don't have access to. Yeah. Somebody says they have at least two of their phone numbers. Well, I hope their phone numbers are listed here. The person who just said they have their phone numbers, do me a favor. Just text them. Just a few simple letters, paalive.us. We've been tweeting at these people all day. So, except for Seagal. Ooh, man. I'm only like...
A whole process here. If they click on that, they got to install Zoom on their phone. And
if they don't already have Zoom, what are they doing? Hey, listen. By the way, I'm glad you said that. I want to put myself over. I have been watching Sam Shad. I love Sam Shad. Johnny Brew has been feeling a little bit down because he doesn't get enough viewers and everything. Meanwhile, like Sam Shad gets like 30 fucking viewers on like really good interviews that he does. So, really? You know, yeah, dude, like on YouTube. Like, I don't know how many old people watch it on fucking Channel
they
X.
They watch it straight on TV.
Yeah, Channel X and Reno watches shit. But I would imagine a lot of people rewatch on YouTube, especially if it's like, hey, did you see what that guy said? You know, that one asshole? How can I not make
Well,
this
that's
bigger?
Saying that nothing exciting really happens.
Right, but I love watching the show. It's my kind of shit, you know.
And, so you're kind of biased towards it. Actually, nobody watches it, Chris.
I know, right? And he's like the big deal guy, right? But I forgot what I was going to say, but yeah, I mean Johnny's been feeling like, you know, he's unloved and
unloved in what way?
Well, no, he doesn't get any views and all that shit.
Obviously shadow banned.
Yeah, and then this shit is very niche anyway. You know what I mean?
Like, yeah, it's not going to pop up in YouTube's algorithm anywhere.
And nobody's searching for it. You know what I mean? Nobody's going.
Yeah, even if you follow the show, it won't even pop up in their algorithm.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
It just doesn't.
Oh, there's been people that watch on Facebook that are like, how come I don't get the fucking notifications? I'm like, I don't know. I do. But, I mean, I'm subscribed under, like, 7 pages, so if I don't get the notification, I'm going to be like, that's weird. Man.
Yeah.
All right, so let's find somebody here. Why no political party? Should we call somebody like Kamisha Monica Lenoir and say...
For running... Yeah, yeah. What's up? What party are you in?
Yeah, like, why would you do...
Her and let her explain... It might be brilliant. Yeah, call her.
All right, so let me text here. Ooh, that's an interesting phone number. She's got a Hotmail account. All right. Man,
I'm going to put... Oh, All I'm seeing is the original window.
You don't see the page that I'm sharing?
List. No, no, because it popped up a new window.
Oh, because I changed it. I think if I do it, yeah. Show thumbnail video like that, does it show up?
I don't know. It's still showing just Clark candidate filing.
Oh, that's all I have up right now.
No, just the main page
yeah.
of Google?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you were looking at
the dude. Dude. Oh, no. What happened? Oh, did you see it?
What? No.
You ever go fishing and you get a nibble?
Uh-uh.
Sharelle clicked on the link, man. She was here, bro.
Ran away?
She was here, man.
It wasn't her,
bro. It says Sharelle, admit. And I was about to admit, and then it disappeared. It happened.
So she might be still installing it.
Hold on. Let's see. Maybe. Oh, man. So Seagal doesn't
even... mugs.
Seagal doesn't even know who we are. That's cool.
She shouldn't.
Right? Former chair.
Yeah. Three-time national delegates.
Current trustee.
Nobody.
Wait. Number one. Blah. There we go. That's cool. Former chair, current trustee, number one, blah, blah. That's cool. Whatever. Oh, yes. I will definitely give a producer credit to this person if they want one. All right. Shit. I don't want to text these people with my number, dude. That's the problem. Like, I wonder...
You don't have a Google Voice?
I do, man, but I use it for school.
I don't
have a second one, man. I had a good 702, and then I went to go and try and get a different Google Voice.
No, just call that candidate you said has no party. I'm interested in understanding that mindset.
Sharelle has a personal family matter. That's cool. Why'd she click on the link then? Like, that was weird. But all right, that's fine.
So that's somebody. Oh, that's a media manager.
Who are the other candidates? Might have their numbers. Joey. Let's talk to Joey. I want to talk to who else? You want to talk to Mac?
If Joey gets on the show, he's going to become governor.
You want to talk to Mac Miller?
No, that's all right.
Yeah.
I don't need to see that.
Who else is fun? All right. I like Alan Bigelow. I like, who's the Dr. Petrick? He's cool. I don't want to talk to any of these fools in 13. Maybe. Okay. There's the one guy that's not Vim Miller and not Stephen Delisle. But he's a cop. I can't remember his name. But his signs have been getting torn up, too. Might be some anti-cop sentiment up here in AD 13.
Sheriff?
No, for AD 13. He's running. Here, let me go down to AD 13. I have the fucking resource right in front of me. Like an asshole. I could call him.
Yeah.
Him, I would give my phone number to. He's probably already got it. He's a cop.
All right. Talk about vandalization. Yeah.
Yeah. Let's see. All right. Yeah, I'll just text him and say, hey, man, I'm an assembly one. And all right. I'm doing my podcast. I noticed some of your signs are getting jacked up. All right. Let's see. Stephen Delisle, Brian Hibbets. That's him. Brian Hibbets. Huh?
What did Sharelle say? Like Sharelle said Sharelle has the family matter?
Yeah.
That came through on what? On text?
Yeah, somebody's
in the Zoom.
Somebody's producing for me on a separate chat.
Oh, gotcha.
Yeah. Gotcha. And they're like they're on super secret probation, so they're not allowed to yeah.
Gotcha.
Yeah, oh, Anna Sigler from spilling the CCSD tea, she would be good to have on because you used to be a CCSD employee. I am as well. But she said she tried to join, but her kids are being loud. She's awesome, but her kids are being loud. What's
we have
up?
Another connection now. We have another connection. That's
how's
crazy.
That? What do you mean? The CCSD? Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah. That's correct. I never thought about it.
I know, right? Yeah, you're a former employee. I mean, you were actually involved in some of the software.
I buried that.
My
buried. I was like, oh shit, I work for the school district.
Yeah. My wife will sometimes go like, you know, this thing that you use? And I'm like, yeah. And she goes like, Carl, I think like built some version of that. And I'm like, oh, good. Nice. Very nice.
Help build. We had some good cats in the IT department.
Oh yeah. Well, I mean like, just like I worked in a Michelin star restaurant, I claim that, you know, I'm a Michelin star expediter. All right, let me text fucking this dude. Oh, man, what's his name? Fucking Brian Hibbets. Who else we got? Give me some more names. Who else is on the fuck. I don't want to talk to Steve. I want to talk to Brian Hibbets.
What office is he running for?
Mary Lim. Is that Miss Fix-It? Oh, shit. Oh, Anna Binder's in. Woo! There we go. We could talk about some of these school board candidates. Because I've already advocated for the school board trustee spelling bee. The trustee spelling bee. It's such a good idea. Anna could make that happen. I can't make shit happen.
You know, that's actually kind of funny. Sorry, I just missed like the last couple seconds while I was waiting to get in.
No, I was just, I was prepping everybody saying that it's good you came on because we need to have a trustee spelling bee. I was just going to prime you for that particular subject.
You know, it's rough, okay? Because I'm a very fast typer on my keyboard, like on my phone, whatever. And so sometimes when I'm like doing multiple things and whatever, I will hit send and there's lots of spelling mistakes. So Twitter does suck because there is no edit button. Sometimes, well, I mean, like, honestly, come on, guys. How many?
Well, no, I'm not talking about tweets. I'm talking about websites where you could have someone go back and proofread it. And then when somebody does proofread it and makes fun of you, you go, whatever, you're a hater, instead of fixing it. You know, if a student if a student called me a hater because I told him something was misspelled, then it would have a problem.
Yeah, but it happens. So, I mean, I don't know why people care so much about it, you know? Like, I can easily still read what you said and get it, you know?
I think it goes to the basic, if you're going to be somebody who's setting curriculum or deciding things for teachers and students, you should probably be a pretty decent level student or teacher yourself.
Well, they don't have that curriculum. That's done by the state.
Yeah, so. I don't know. I don't know what they do. I obviously am going to expose myself.
Right, I get where you're going, but I don't know. So in the world of social media, I think people pay too much attention to those little things sometimes.
But I'm talking about semi-permanent stuff. Like if I wrote a book and it was misspelled, I'd be very upset. Yeah, yeah. When I put out a tweet and it's misspelled, I go, oh shit, and I let it go. But a website, I mean, you gotta get that shit. And you're paying somebody. I know some of these trustee candidates that are paying people, and some of these candidates that are paying people for that.
Right. But I mean, look at media anyways. Like you open up like any mainstream media story, you're going to find typos in there and they get paid to do that too.
Yeah. Well, they don't care. I take screen grabs of their mistakes from the news and then I repost it in the comments and then I tell them you need to hire a copy editor. And I know their copy editor reads that and goes, ah, you got us again. I know people in the television news world and they do read that stuff and they do get to like, haha, you suck at your job to one another. So who do you support for all the trustee spots? Do you support the same people as that show I'm not allowed to talk about, Veterans in Politics? I know they endorse some people and that's cool, but Who you got? Do you want to pick winners or do you want to pick who you want?
Are you asking me?
Yeah.
Oh.
I'm trying to fucking I'm trying to text this dude in AD 13 at the same time and Carl won't fucking talk and I can't talk and type at the same time. So I don't want to sound like a Momo. I don't want to spell anything because he's wrong. He's a cop. So I'm like, hey, do you want to buy some meth? It's like, you know.
Yeah, I couldn't. You guys were having a chat. I was just listening.
Sorry. Yeah, I was trying to set something up, and then so I could look at this real quick. And
oh, gotcha.
We obviously have some, you know, good candidates. I guess depends what side of the community you look at that from, that are running. But I think one thing through and through that people need to focus on is we need to keep people who, you know, kind of stand up against the rubber stamping.
Yeah.
As best as they can. And honestly, I don't really think it matters who that person is, as long as they're willing to stand and do that part. You know, Linda Cavazos has been through hell and back with the pandemic. You know, she, well, and they all did. They all sat there for it, but she took a lot of the brunt force of public comment, you know. So I could never imagine what that was like sitting there. I don't even know how they kept straight faces half the time.
Isn't it weird that Danielle Ford played a little game and didn't file until the last minute? Even Chuck Muth blew it. He's like, Danielle didn't file.
No, hold on. In her total defense, that's ADHD at its best. You know you have something important to do, so you put it off until the very last moment. So,
yeah, I guess so. I mean, it seemed like she was playing a game. Does she work with somebody, or does she have a consultant?
I thought she had her own media, like marketing company.
Oh man, she's not doing a great job. I used to watch her for like tips on using green screen and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And you know, for
she hasn't been doing those. I know I've seen them, but yeah, she hasn't updated anything on that for a while. So I don't know. I don't really ever have conversations with her about what she does in her life. It's always business related, you know.
A lot of time. I found out a lot about being a single mom from her. I had my mom was single for a few years, but it was whatever. She did a lot of that stuff. I was like, I could skip all this, but yeah. But the media stuff, the stuff that she was doing with video, seriously, I was like, I did not know that.
Yeah, so. And she was very detailed. Those were some great kind of do-it-yourself, you know, learn-to-do-it-yourself videos.
And then she gave me good content. I had to comb through it all. I swear to God, it was like delivered to me. Like I know Johnny Brew played it one time where I had this little clip where she was sitting in her car. She did a little tweet, vine or something where she said, I guess I fucked up or something. And it was the only, I was like, I'm done. I just clipped that, saved it. And I was like, I'm done. Like added it to my video. Like, damn, that was easy. And she's like, wow, he must have gone through all my shit to find that. And I'm like, nope. Oh, Sharelle's back. Here we go. Are you ready, Carl? Are you ready, Anna? All right, I clicked to admit her. I don't know what happened. She just clicking on the link.
I tell you, it's somebody's got to install this on their phone, Chris. They're just trying to figure it out. You remember when you first installed Zoom?
Oh,
you didn't
man.
Know how the hell it worked. You're like, what's this? What's that? Everybody was like talking on mute for the first 3 months.
That's what I was going to tell you. Friggin' John Lee, I've been clowning on him for his background, his lack of background, whatever is going on. The dude went to green screen. I was so stoked. I know he's watching me. I know he listens to what I tell him. Just like, John Lee, the guy running for governor that had the old iPad issue. Google.
He wasn't. Go ahead.
Oh, I was going to say, I feel like I'm the only one out there in the Twitter universe slamming him for the child porn.
No, I just don't use that phrase because I don't want to get boosted off of certain platforms. Yeah. But I always say, Google John Lee iPad. That's all I have to say.
I know, but people are lazy. People don't always do stuff like that.
Oh, I know, but it's...
You have to hand it to them.
And you know what? Even when you hand it to them, I've had this argument with people who have obviously never owned an iPad. Oh, John Lee will be on April 23rd on the Johnny Brew Show. I hope he gets asked about that iPad because I never got anything on an iPad that I didn't ask for. And if I had any sort of technology that got something like that without me asking for it, I damn sure wouldn't bring it to a cop. I would have shredded it because it's cursed.
Wait. He took it to the FBI.
No, he took it to the North Las Vegas police chief.
Oh, that's right. And then the FBI did investigate it. Yeah.
Sure.
Right.
What the fuck?
You don't remember this?
That's like a lie that just gets out of control.
This is what a sociopath the dude is. He did a show with Nephi. I don't know if you read Chuck Moose articles. Wefi Khalifi, Kaliki, Uliki, whatever. The dude that had the whole thing with the lady that went to get her kid. And, you know, pulling people's bond and shit like that. But, you know, fucking shit. I got sidetracked. What, Chuck? I did. Who the fuck are we talking Chuck. About? Who the fuck are we talking about?
Nephi
and Chuck are going after each other. But John Lee and Nephi did a fucking video. That's what I was going to say. They did a video together, like a top 10 list. And one of the top 10 things was him goofing on the iPad thing. Like, he made a joke about it. And I swear to God, I wish I had saved the video. I saved a few videos since then, but I did not save it. And when I got into a little pissing match with Nephi, I asked him about it. I said, hey, where's that video? And he's like, I still have it. He still has it. So
wow. Yeah. So it might be something more on that, right?
He's going to lord it over John's head. You know, if John were to get elected, he can be like, hey, remember that time you made light of the fact that you downloaded CP on a fucking iPad? You fucking idiot.
What the fuck?
And then you brought it to the cops? Like, what, oh my fuck? God, dude. I don't know why anybody, like...
So how did that happen, do you think? Like, he was using it, and he didn't realize, like, everything's trackable on the internet? And then he learned, like, one day, and he's like, oh, shit. That he learned that it was all trackable, and he's like, how do I get this? I'll just say it showed up magically and take it to a cop.
Yeah, it was a pop-up. I clicked on a pop-up on my iPad.
Oh, yeah.
Not how iPads work.
Well, technically, it is possible for a rogue agency to do that to your device using this program called Pegasus 2. They can just jack into anybody's phone. You know, it's a multi-million dollar, like, you know, countries own it type of thing. So if John Lee was ever a target of, say, Saudi Arabia... You know, Saudi Arabia could get in there and inject porn.
I got you.
Into your device.
I got you.
So it is possible. It is possible. So that's why the FBI had to get involved.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Okay. Uh-huh.
If I was the victim of that kind of, that high level of fuckery, the last people I'd run to is the cops. They must, if they did that. Okay. No. Listen, if somebody did that, if somebody planted that shit on there and then they're like, well, he's just going to shred this iPad. We'll just have to keep firing. He's an idiot. He'll fucking eventually, I mean, he's a troglodyte. A Luddite. He doesn't like technology. He's not an idiot, but he doesn't like technology. Yeah. Eventually, he'll fuck up, right? And the first time they fired that bullet, boop, pop up, and he goes, CP, I'm down. And he clicks on it and then goes, oh, shit. And he runs right to the cops. The people that did it must have been like, how was that so fucking, they just like packed up the van and all the shit that they had, all these iPads that they had and just like... Went home, like, well, fuck, man. The budget's all spent, and we didn't have to... One iPad and one smash of a button. That was it. And he told on himself. And now nobody believes it. When you tell them, they go, oh, I've had problems with iPads. And I'm like, those kind of problems? Like,
right. I've had my iPad for, like, 8 years, and I've never, knock on wood, had a problem with it. Especially not of that totality.
Right. Yeah, I mean, they're kind of designed to not do that.
Are there actual details on, like, counts and numbers and stuff like that ever came out? Or was it just kind of vague?
Nope, it was very
vague.
It was
just like...
There was, like, one or two news articles about it. Just a couple. And then it was done.
Hmm. Yeah.
Hey, guys.
He was compromised.
What was that?
Sharelle.
I heard some.
Hey, Sharelle. Hey. Sharelle is here. She's been listening this whole time.
I have been.
All right, right on.
Yeah, we talk a lot.
Yeah, so, no, I had a death in the family 2 days ago, so we've kind of been out of touch. So I'm sorry, I guess you guys wanted to pop on. So.
Oh my God, sorry about
welcome,
that.
Welcome, welcome.
Yeah, sorry to hear that.
Good note. Let's go.
I noticed that you were talking about some of your signs being damaged, and I've got this guy Brian Hibbets.
Okay.
Can I stop sharing screen? Maybe that'll help.
Is Brian on?
We can't see Sharelle. No, I texted him, but I sent him the link. But I noticed in AD 13, this guy has signs, and it's been windy, but only his signs are damaged. So, right. I know you've got some pretty high profile signs. I haven't noticed them damaged up here in Northtown, but where are yours getting torn up?
So I actually have reports from about 5 different parts of town. Some of them are cut. Like fully like sliced down the middle. Some are missing. Some actually people witnessed. One of the pictures I just posted, they witnessed two individuals taking my signs out of their yards. and then taking them and throwing them on the side of the street. I had someone else just call me and say, hey, my yard sign's missing. So it's kind of been a trend across all of Vegas. So I haven't been able to pinpoint one area. So someone's on a mission.
So is it, yeah. I wonder if it's just you, if we could like keep track of this somehow, because yeah, like I'm seeing them in AD13, but only for Brian. I don't know. Maybe we'll start that.
Yeah. Yeah. Yours sounds more than kids. That sounds kind of an organized effort.
Targeted.
Yeah. Kind of a targeted effort there. Yeah. And 2014, my slimes is just sliced and diced. It was like Freddy Krueger got hold of them.
Anything, like, why destroy signs? Like, I've heard a couple of other individuals saying the same thing, but why signs? Why are you destroying signs? Like, I mean,
obviously, because it's a considerable investment, right? Like, how much is one of those signs, each A-frame? You know, there's a cost. Like, I got it down to like 700 per, you know, with a setup and everything, but some of them go up to 2,000-3,000 on the size, so it's a considerable investment. So it's basically they're robbing your campaign of that money,
right? Taking out the rebar, they're taking time to take out the rebar in the sign.
Yeah.
What'd you just say?
That's a politic. I just said that. That's a politician still in it.
Yep.
Somebody involved in politics. It's not kids.
Are they worth money?
Costs money. Well, yeah, rebar costs a lot of money.
But can you recycle rebar? I mean,
yes.
You could just reuse it on their side.
You reuse it on your side. Absolutely.
Did I predict that or what? I predicted that, Chris.
I learned how to decorate my yard with Christmas ornaments by using rebar and plywood, and I just put a strap on the back from doing, you know, like yard signs and people's signs. Also, during the housing crisis back in 08, we used to climb up on all the signs that used to have, you know, coming soon, and put our signs way up high so nobody could get to them.
Creative.
Dangerous.
So it's a considerable investment. So your opponents or people who don't like you know that you're going to, you know, it's going to upset you. It's going to get under your skin. You just got to kind of wash it out of your mind and just keep moving forward. I mean, they're going to do those childish games, and it happens every cycle. And it's usually to the person who's the biggest threat to the powers that be. So take it as a badge of honor.
Right. Yeah. No, upset. No, I think one of the funniest things is, you know, just like on this journey, so many people, you know, give that precursor, hey, I don't want to offend you. And I was like, you guys, I got into politics. If you think I'm going to get offended easily or upset easily, you know, I shouldn't even be in this place. You know, I've had people straight up need to let a real woman do this or a real man do this job, like a real man. So you got female. She got up to address, you know, the entire group, and her question, you know, became a statement that I should let a real man do the job.
Jeez.
So, yeah.
And that man is Adam Laxall, I assume.
Did you know, Sharelle, if you ever run into Adam, you may want to mention this. I doubt he'll admit to it. But when Adam first turned up in Nevada again and was running for attorney general there, he would do the Pledge of Allegiance because he's a veteran. And I am a veteran as well of a couple of different branches. But I was in the Navy just like Adam. And when I saw his salute, I said, that is garbage. That is wrong, wrong, wrong. So I sent him the regs in a tweet. I sent him the correct and proper way to tweet. And I promise you that the next time we had a meeting, the Clark County Republican Party, he gave the Pledge of Allegiance and did it correctly. He saluted correctly. And I haven't seen him do it wrong since. So I'm going to take full credit for that. But yeah.
You're busting his chops.
Busted his chops, but he heard me. So yeah, I mean, he didn't even know how to salute until an enlisted guy had to teach him. They don't salute a lot in D.C., I think. They walk around without their hats on, you know, so.
Oh, geez.
I mean, I have people that say, like, I read the comments of his stuff, and they're like, oh, I knew his dad. And I'm like, you knew Pete Dominici? Like, that's crazy. And they don't get the joke.
Puzzled. They're puzzled by that. Yeah. It's a puzzling.
What's up?
Is anyone else disappointed that Rod Meyer didn't run for anything in midterms?
Rodimer is in Texas.
No, he's not. He came back. And this was really odd because he came back literally with enough time to establish residency in a district to run, and he didn't file for anything. So I was a little shocked that he didn't.
That's weird. Yeah, he does own a taco shop here, and but he is one of Carrie Buck's people now. So I don't know. Maybe she convinced him to wait for something else. Yeah, they held all their little boo-boo ass meetings in their taco shop. I sat across the street at Cafe Brige and watched them have a meeting one time.
It's weird. It's weird, really, how we're so divided. Like, why are we divided against like what should be the most obvious common enemy in these socialist communists that we're battling politically? Like, we should all just be united. But we're all butthurt. We're all butthurt for some reason, for some little issue. I just don't understand it. Like
some little issue, like some fucking grifter that gives money to Democrats and the Chinese Republican Party and sells fake fucking Trump merchandise. Just a fucking small issue. Minor issue.
So maybe we're not on the same side.
And there's way more minor, you want to kind of label it minor. There's a lot of issues, and I don't think they're minor.
Yeah, I mean, we can argue all day long about crap we can stick on guns. But, you know, when you're just stealing from the president who happens to be a Republican, and then there's actual tweets of people going, I sell fake Chinese Trump shit to dumb Trump tards.
That's the
and then
meme.
I give the money.
The meme going around.
And then I give the money to Planned Parenthood. And I'm like, it's fucking brilliant. Like, stop buying the shit. Or stop selling it at the party meetings. So, fuck those people. They're not Republicans.
No matter what, you know, sorry. Just kind of going back to what Carl was talking about, just the division, it's amazing. Like, how well we're tanking and losing because of division. At some point, there are obviously people who were offensive, who did a bunch of things that are against kind of everything that we love, everything that Republicans stand for. But there has to be some sort of coming together in order to win Nevada back, because I don't believe that we're purple or it's just, but they're laughing at us because of how divided we are. It's pretty impressive.
But Sharelle, last time we had a Republican governor and a Republican majority in both houses, we got the biggest tax hike ever jammed up our butts. So those of us that were around then are really burned by that. So like we're watching hard because like Steven Silberkraus is still around. Some of those guys are still around and they'll come back around. Mike Roberson, like they just they're lurking constantly. They got to be called out.
Oh, I agree. I'm not saying that. What I'm saying is that the rest of us have to find a way to come together in order to beat the real enemy, which is socialism. Because those guys do need to get rid of. Like, but there's a whole entire bigger group that I see that needs to be destroyed first and foremost. So just talking about priorities. That's all.
No, I got you. I've seen it as a.
It should be clear. Like, it should be so clear. Like, how do they wake up in the morning?
I've seen it as an analogy of a castle. We have a castle. Being a Republican is a castle. But unfortunately, inside the castle walls, we have assholes. And they're trying to kill us from within. I'm looking over the castle wall and I'm like, look at that shit. Like, we're in big trouble. But then I look down on the other side of the castle wall and I got assholes stabbing everybody in the back. Like, I got to deal with 100%. These assholes. I got to deal with these assholes inside the castle walls. And maybe I'll be equipped to deal with
it. Test?
But the
have
problem is.
Have you created a test to find out who the good ones are and the bad ones are? So
no,
can
I don't.
Just like gather everybody in the right side of the castle?
No, but I do have hope because I know that the Democrats pretend, but they do the same shit. They're biting each other's asses, man. That lady that's running the state party is a completely different Democrat than the old Democrats that used to run things. Well, and they walk around with a smile like, but they fucking hate each other.
The Democrats had to change state law because their party got hijacked by communists. So I don't think they have any better over there. I just think they have what's left with the Harry Reid machine, right?
Yeah, yeah.
He built an elaborate machine that is still running. It is still running.
Parts are flying off of it. Yeah.
Parts are flying off. Because, you know, the communists, you know, infiltrated that, so they're still within it. But they changed they basically changed state law, right, to create their own new party, to get around the communists.
Something like that. Yeah, they pulled a Team Nevada move.
Similar to what happened to us in 08 through 2012. So it's kind of 10 years behind.
Yeah.
But something's brewing in there.
Yeah, yeah. There's problems, you know, in all the communities that are involved with the Democrats. They have problems and issues with one another. They just they cover it up better than we do. I don't know. Nobody watches what we do anyway. Like me pissing on Republicans that are rhinos, no one notices. Mm. No one's going to see this. My kids. Right?
Yeah, this is for posterity's sake. This is like the I told you so video that'll show up in the crater that is the United States.
I told you. I went and made a Sharelle voice and an Anna Binder voice and I just edited them in. Go ahead, Sharelle.
Done and done. No, I just wanted to pop in because I missed you guys last night. I'm going to go spend time with family, but I want to say hi, guys. Love what you're doing. And
We think you're awesome. Chinese EMPs are a real thing. Like yeah. I laughed for only a second.
So we can talk about that. Yeah, the EMPs are important.
No, I would love to. You know, I've been walking around. Everyone's talking about, you know, changing our world, getting new cars. You know, obviously we don't even have enough lithium to mine in order to give everyone these electric cars. But we don't even have EMP protection. You know, there's so many different things we can have conversations about. But, you know.
Sharelle, before you go, since you just mentioned that. And I don't know why no other politician is taking a stance on this for their campaigns, but, and I post about it constantly, but up north, BLM has completely shattered some tribal land, the Thacker Pass. And it's just like going through, there's a couple of us that are all over it, but it's going like so under the radar. And I really think that it was what they paid for Elon Musk to get his factory here. But they're making it a lithium mine.
And you know, yep. I speak to, like, just because I actually haven't been tracking that. There are so many things that I am tracking on, and that wasn't one of them yet. So I'm going to read up on that so I can have a conversation with you next time. But I haven't yet, so.
Yeah, no worries.
Right, we look forward to that conversation.
Thank you, Sharelle. Anytime you want to drop in, every Saturday night at 6.
All right, bye, guys.
Right on.
All right, thanks for joining.
I almost said love you. Like, what?
Don't fanboy on me.
Now I can't say bad things about her. Shit.
Ah!
Yeah. That's cool. Us. Yeah. Ah. I believe her. God did tell her to run, of course. What?
Speaks to us. He speaks to us all.
Max in my comments. What's that? Oh, somebody is working on creating the rhino test. We do have Rhino de Mayo coming up. So,
yeah,
May we 5th. Will. In May, the month of May, is Rhino de Mayo. There's going to be a lot of talk about rhinos because we're trying to weed them out before the primaries. But it looks like Rob Kafka says probably the Patriot Impact. Ah, shit. Let me get to that. Dude, that's exciting. So, yeah, let me definitely play this. Because we just had a Senate candidate on, so here we go.
I think I found someone who can make an impact.
You go to thepatriotimpact.com if you refresh your browser. I should be somewhere in there, the PAA podcast, and I'm on the candidate page.
Oh, you got listed?
Yeah. I don't know. I don't know.
Are you ready?
Yeah, Matt has wheels. I haven't actually checked it recently, but I know where I'm supposed to be, so I just I pretty much see it there now. But I am listed as a candidate as well, and then there's cool comments. And you feel free to go to thepatriotimpact.com and look for Nevada candidates like myself or Mac Miller, who commented.
What's Mac?
Oh, God, what did he have to say?
No, he said, we can't know about everything, and I'm part Cherokee.
Well, then, great.
Talking about Sharelle not knowing about it. Yeah.
Oh. Yeah, Thacker. No, yeah. But that is why social media is really great. And if you read enough, you know, like I open almost everything and read it, you learn a lot of things.
All right. I have to apologize to Johnny Brew and Rob Kafka because I didn't know how I was supposed to put this over, but I do want to give them credit. Rhino de Mayo is their idea. Now I have to say it. Because they're going to be interviewing rhinos all the month of May. So everybody that's on Johnny's show...
Oh, my God.
...has been pre-shit on, you're a rhino. Congratulations.
They're all going to cancel now.
Right?
Well, wait a minute.
If they watch this...
I've been on that show.
But have you been in the month of May?
No.
May.
Oh, actually, you know what? I don't know.
That's a great idea. Johnny Brew, I love you. I love you.
That's some funny shit.
Yeah. Alan Bigelow
commented. Nobody's going to go.
What's so up, Alan? Alan Bigelow. Alan Bigelow for City Council, PAALive.us. Let's talk about Victoria Seaman. He's running against Victoria.
Oh my God. He's my new favorite.
He's in the comments.
Where is Sarah when we need her?
Oh, I know. I sent her the link and everything. Apparently, she's in Ukraine.
Well, I know where she is.
The only coverage I watch of the war is her jumping between Russia and Ukraine. I'm like, what is happening? Like, this is weird. I don't watch CNN. I just watch Sarah Cirillo.
Watch Sarah.
Yeah. I mean, do you communicate with her?
Sarah?
Chris?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah, just tell her not to walk up to the unexploded munitions in the street.
Oh, I know. All those photos. Like, hey,
I'm like, please step away from that.
Look at my new wig with another undetonated munition. Like, please
don't
stop.
Get anywhere near those. There's undetonated munitions. You're literally saying it as your head is next to it. It was like stressful for me.
She's such a wrestling fan that we were going to do this, and we may still do it. This would be amazing if she were in the shit at a time when you would want to be live on a real reputable show to call in here and then just talk about wrestling or local politics and not anything about what the fuck's going on behind.
Oh my God. Actually, apparently the last 36 to 48 hours haven't been very pleasant where she's at. So,
I wouldn't expect it. You don't go there. I mean, the only good part is there's less Arabs there, I guess. Like, less likely to lop your head off. Seems like they've been pretty decent. Except for the shelling.
Chris told me about it like last week or something that she was over there.
Yeah.
And I followed it, and I was like scrolling through. I'm like, what? I mean, I can't. It's a little bit, I guess it's a little bravery there, right? Like, to go over there, that's wild.
Suicidal.
Like, I would never do that.
Suicidal.
Suicidal or brave? I mean, what?
It's brave. It is courageous, especially being trans in that region of the world. It's something, obviously, not a lot of people jump ship to.
It's something at a whole nother level.
Yeah, Sarah was one of the first that I saw, one of two self-reporters that showed up there and started broadcasting. So I'm super proud of her.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's
I'm amazed.
It is wild. Yeah, I don't know. I got no fucking business.
Okay, back to Seaman.
Victoria, yes.
That shit's so funny.
Well, she's apparently, I don't know, they haven't gotten, she stole the Veterans in Politics endorsement, apparently, but she's been endorsed by them before. Oh, I don't know who they've endorsed recently. I saw, that they did a bunch of interviews, and those were pretty cool. Jane Addams was on there. She actually walked in the middle of one. I invited her on here, but Victoria claimed Alan Bigelow's victory, I guess. Alan got the endorsement. That's why he doesn't come on here, because he was told not to.
Over Victoria, yeah.
Yeah, because
any wise consultant would tell their candidate never to call the show.
I know, right? What?
Yeah,
I mean,
we have to clean up our act now. So
what
we can make this viral?
What if? See, I've interviewed two candidates that are not up for re-election this cycle, but what if it plays out? Where, I don't know, Sharelle somehow wins Senate, and then I don't know. You know, I become a kingmaker, and people are like, oh, shit, we missed a huge opportunity. Oh,
gotta go with Chris Dyer.
Yep.
Juggalo Patriot.
Yeah, Alan ain't jumping on. He says, you guys crack. Apparently, we crack. Probably meant to say me up.
Can't have fun.
Yeah, he goes, crack me up. Yeah.
Good.
They can't. Some of them can't, because I don't know if you watched some of the previous episodes, but Johnny Brew was having all these cats on his show. And then they were all like, I'm a Christian. And then Alan said, oh, there's a bunch of us, and we're the Christian warrior candidates. And I was like, damn, that's crazy. Like, they formed a faction. But then I was like, what if somebody's more Christian and running?
Maybe that's, is it the Super Friends I was talking about?
Yes, but are you Christian enough? What if somebody is more, you know what I mean? Like, are you liberty enough? Like, what if there's a better Paul Tard running it? You know, like, it's...
Well, I'm running into that. We're running into that in some spots.
Yeah. Alan says he's not scared. PAALive.us. And we can talk smack about Victoria, because Yeah, we've had a long history of.
Please make sure
he knows that's the Zoom.
Listen, I've missed 4 years of politics, so I need to know everything this demon's done.
He's watching live, so he knows if he hits that PAALive.us link, it brings him in to.
It was tricky for me the first time I ever tried to get in. Remember? I was like, and then I gave up.
I'm telling you, it's a tricky thing.
It can be, I suppose. I tried to make it as easy as possible, took out all the password options and all that stuff. So, and it's always the same link. So even if I'm not there, you can sit in the waiting room for a week.
Sweet.
Like, yeah, I tried to make it super simple. Sharelle got in. You got in eventually.
Yeah, use the link you put in Twitter to come in, and so it just opened Zoom right up on my phone. But the one I had difficulty with was when I was doing it from my computer and I was watching Facebook Live and hitting that link. But that was a couple months ago.
Well, damn. I probably fixed it since then. I hope so. Oh, Alan says it's not working. See, just like everything. Amazing. Yeah, I don't know what to tell you. Technology. Yeah. That's wild. Yeah. All right, so he's actually trying to get in. Shit.
All right.
Now I kind of want to wait. I know. I do want to wait.
I'm like a kid before Christmas. I'm on Christmas Eve right now. I'm just like, oh, it's coming.
That's great. It's episode 100. Fucking, Sharelle jumped in. That was dope. Anna Binder's here spilling CCSD tea. And I mean, with one former and one current CCSD employee. That's pretty cool.
I think I worked there from 2000. I worked with CCSD from 2003 to 2008. I was an outside vendor for the first few years, and then I worked for CCSD after that. It was an interesting ride, very interesting ride. It seems like the school's just completely collapsed since then. I mean, it felt like everybody was trying to do good in the schools, but now they've just, was it before COVID? Was it falling apart? Is this just a result of the like COVID stuff?
Well, it depends what exactly you're referencing.
Like, just it seems like there's no organization anymore. Like, there's like utter revolts. It seems
COVID has created a behavior bubble.
Yeah. Well, that bubble, when you go back and kind of read everything from like the school safety task force meetings that were had before the pandemic. We were already on an upward trend of violence and increased violence.
Yeah.
And then the pandemic hit, and then we had a bunch of kids home alone for like almost 2 years for the most part. And then we pushed them back out where they had to be responsible, like behaved kids. And how do you do? They came back feral is what I said. I was like, these kids have come back feral.
Wow.
One of the schools that I volunteer at, a middle school, It at the beginning of the year, it was so bad when I would go into the office, there would be so many kids waiting to figure out if they were getting like sent home, in-house suspension. You know what I mean? They were like just lined up waiting, you know, and then the assistant principal's in there with a chicken with her head cut off, trying to figure it all out. That's calmed down a lot. Like now it started calming down after Christmas break at that school. And so that particular one has about 5 to 10 students that are the issue. But we brought Metro in a couple weeks ago to talk to them, just about their choices. They've been throwing liquor bottles, you know, they're drinking liquor on the way to school and throwing the bottle. Yeah. So this is crazy. So three of them. We're walking to school one day and they were chucking the little mini shot bottles over a wall on the way to school. And the homeowner was sitting in the backyard having coffee, and then all these bottles come, you know, flinging up into his backyard. He actually came out of the house and chased them to the school, and then went in the front door, told the lady at the front desk, and they have a really good camera system. So they were able to pull, he was like, you know, he kind of said what they were wearing. And because he only saw them from the back because they were running from him. And so they pulled the video and, you know, they were able to identify him. But it's like now you got to call the parents, right? And explain to them that, you know, hey, your kid's getting drunk on their way to school. You know, whatnot. It's crazy. And then when I was there last week, when the kids were leaving one of the lunches, we come out of the lunchroom because like it. you go out, they exit out, so it's outdoors. And there's a kid like halfway up on the roof. And we're like, and so they're like, I'm like, what are you doing? And he's like, he like steps down. He steps down and he's like, I wasn't doing anything. And I'm like, okay. Like, go to class. Oh my
He's supposed
God.
To say parkour. Like, if they catch you climbing on something, you just go parkour.
Parkour.
Yeah.
What was crazy is this is a middle schooler who's like 6'1".
Jesus Christ. Right. My kid keeps telling me to go teach.
Too small for him.
My kid keeps telling me that I should teach high school. And I'm like, no way, bro. No way. No way, buddy. I saw a kid at Sam's Club that looked at me funny. And I said, why is that kid? And I said, oh, man, I recognize that kid because I saw her brother, right? And I was like, all right. You know, put the two and two together. And I'm like, all right. So when we were leaving, I was walking by and I'm like, well, this would be weird. Like in the hallway, we do this, right? I'm not waving at random ass kids. So I had to walk over to the dad like a man, you know, hey, these kids go to such and such school. He's like, yeah. So I just started subbing over there. I recognize them. So
my 13-year-old figured out one of his teachers lives in the neighborhood behind us.
Oh, no.
And my 13, he's autistic, so he's a little awkward if you don't know him. Well, he's a little awkward, but so he comes home one day and he's like, Mom, so-and-so lives like right here behind us. And I'm like, okay. And I said, that's really great, but you're not at school, leave her alone. And he's like, I just waved hi and said hi. And I said, perfect, but don't even do that ever again. Leave her alone, unless, you know, like just leave her alone.
Yeah, space. Personal space. Yeah.
No, I told the dad, I said I knew this would eventually happen. I recognized them. Like, I just didn't want him to think that I was just waving at his kids or they were looking at me like, that's the madman. Yeah, right. You know, like, no, hey, I'm not the... <you know? laughs> No, so yeah.
Well, I have six kids in four different schools. We run into their teachers all the time out in public. So we've never in public had an awkward thing. We just say hi and keep going. You know, we don't stop. Again, personal space. I don't bother them outside of school. And I expect my kids not to, too.
I guess. Yeah.
That's a good rule of thumb.
I don't live that close, but, you know, there's only a few Sam's Clubs, so it's bound to happen. Like, I shouldn't see them in my neighborhood.
but to go back to the violence, because it is an important discussion, and so I can send you the link too. I'm on my phone right now because I've got a headache from the wind. But there's a report they came out with in like 2018 that had all of the recommendations, you know, of what to do, like some steps to take and whatnot, and none of them have been done. And then so here we are post pandemic. Not that we had a lot of time to do anything anyways, but you know, we've had time. And then even with closures, they could have put some of that stuff in place while schools were closed, you know, so when they came back. But
are we gonna have teacher cages like in the subways and the buses? are we gonna have to teach from inside of an enclosure?
I'm laughing, but it's seriously like we have to protect. If the teachers aren't safe, the children aren't safe.
Hey, when I set up my next classroom, there's no way my desk is over in the corner. Like
you're right by the door.
Right by the door.
This is a sad commentary.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Slide it right over so your back is to the exit.
Yep. When you come in, you walk behind the desk. Exactly. You know, that's perfect.
Why we protested earlier in the week was because when Jara, you know, they did the press conference, he basically was like, oh, we're going to give him a fucking panic button. You know what I asked? I asked at the
press conference. School?
Hold on. No, I asked one of the teachers at the protest, I said, do you think we should ask CCSD to pay for rape panties? Because then teachers just can put rape panties on and, you know, then at least you don't have to worry about that.
Oh, right? God. Right. Yeah.
I mean, that's
Is this a school or a prison?
Right. But I mean, that's just how ridiculous the two press conferences they've come up with. That's like how ridiculous their conversations are about it right now.
I have been around special ed elementary schoolers, and I'm not opposed to rape panties. They will goose you. You're like, come on, man, what are you doing? Like,
they don't mean to, though.
Oh, you know, I think it's hilarious.
My 6-year-old is autistic too, and when he was much younger, he would come running at you, and you get headbutted there, whether you liked it or not.
I got a dog that does that too. It's ridiculous. You got to learn. You got to learn. I have kids that lay down in front of me, and then if you're not looking, you'll trip over them. You're like, why did you do that? And you're like, oh, it's because you're a kid. It's
right.
Random shit that kids do.
Right. But so they're continuing that protest into the next school board meeting because they're right. You know, and I support them. They're right. But so the board voted for Jara and his staff to have a community meeting before the end of the month. And then he was on Vegas PBS. He had that like panel thing on Vegas PBS. And I think they only broadcasted it on CCSD's Facebook page. It was on
Should have been Channel on TV, 10. Right?
It was. Yeah, it was yeah, on Channel yeah. 10. Sorry, because someone asked me to tune into it, and I was like, what? I was like, I don't even have cable. Like, what?
No, right? Like, so, YouTube, BitChute, Rumble, but Odyssey.
I peeked in on it, and I immediately shut it off because it was a bunch of white people sitting at the table trying to talk about our community. There was no diversity. It was a bunch of cherry-picked fuckers talking about shit that we have solutions for. So I'm interested to see how the
like
community
a board, like a commi- like a, it was like a committee.
No, it was at comprised. The board? No. It the Vegas PBS thing. No, it was comprised of I think like a therapist or something, and then Jara, and then the PTA lady, and somebody else. But it was like just a fucking bunch of white women. Like, okay. I mean, I'm a white woman.
We know about crime in our community, in our HOA gated community.
We're the ones who put up the cameras to catch our neighbors speeding.
Yeah. Don't park in front of my house.
I was so appalled at that. I just shut it off and I was like, wow. So it will be interesting to see how they do the community meetings. You know, I'm super critical of all of the community meetings. So I did give public comment, I think, at the last work session. And I said that we know Jara is capable of good community meetings. He did two of them last year that I approved of. And you know what I'm talking about. So we'll see. You know, we'll see.
Yeah, I don't know what we're going to do when they break us up into 5 different districts.
They're not going to. You think
no.
Legislature is gonna freaking give up 15 years of work?
No. I mean, they would cut it no matter how they cut it. People would be like, well, this is fucked up.
Cutting it is fucked up. So.
Right. Yeah. There's no good way to cut that pie where somebody's not like, well, we got the bone. We knew we would and we did. So, man. It's nice. Yeah, it's one big pot to shit in. Just one big district. I mean, that would be weird, right? Like to have to like try and work within different districts. Like, oh, those assholes next door have health insurance.
But you know, this was, you know, NRS 388G provided that the municipalities were to have their own education advisory committees. And even now, Henderson has one. I think City has one, and North Las Vegas has one, and Moapa has one. And that's it.
Turn them into city schools.
Right, that's what they're doing, right? The micro schools. Let's micro school this.
Well, no, it's going to become Henderson City Schools, North Las Vegas City Schools, Las Vegas City Schools, Summerlin City Schools.
And then the county school will be super dope. Hey, what do you think about this? Yeah. I don't know if you've heard me talk about this, but I talked about it last week, Anna. They're building Northeast Technical Career Academy over right next door to Legacy High School. Like,
okay, so they're doing that because, you know, I'm on the zoning committee, right?
I do now.
Okay, I am a member of our CCSD AZAC committee.
Nice.
And so that that magnet program is because Legacy and the Arborview are so overcrowded. So hold on, this is the catch though, because magnet schools attract good students, right?
Right, yeah.
So it's going to attract the good students from the neighboring schools. And then what are you going to have left in the neighboring schools? You're going to have the children who need a lot of attention. And so I'm hoping
we talked about this last week.
Yeah, I'm hoping they'll be able to get a little more, one-to-one attention and whatnot, you know.
Oh, I got you. Yeah, yeah. I was saying Legacy would become a prison with a high school team, but you're saying that maybe we're reducing the numbers of the kids that are doing well will pretty allow much. More attention for the middling kids to kind of become the well-doing kids.
Yes. Well, because right now, with how crowded it is, they don't have the staff. You know, they don't have staff. So you reduce the population, and then, they can get to them. So I'm actually looking forward to seeing how that helps them, and I'm hoping that they thrive, you know? That's what we want any of our students to do. And what's interesting is, I don't know if you've seen this. Hang on, sorry, one second. My son just walked up. What's up, bud? Oh, okay. The state has been having these, they hired a company to do some stakeholder meetings about the future of education. And there's been three of them, I think, so far. I've attended every one. And at the last meeting, they were talking about student-based learning. And so we've had a program, I guess, in Nevada. And let me know if you don't know what student-based learning is. I think you do.
I'm going to pretend I do. If I don't, I should.
Okay, so the student-based learning is where what I keep screaming about is meet students where they're at. You can't keep pushing non-proficient students forward and expecting them to succeed. And we have the money and the time to meet them where they're at and let them move forward, you know? And so at this last meeting with Knowledge Works is the name of the company they hired. They were talking about bringing that plan in fully into schools. And guess the timeline on it for full implementation.
6 years.
2035. I said that's 2-3 generations. Wow. If you wait to implement this to 2035, we've lost 3 more generations.
Yeah.
What the fuck?
Jeez.
What was the major objection to it?
Oh, no, no.
Or was there no objection?
There was no objection. It was just...
Well, there must be if they're not going to do it this century.
Right.
God. Well, Years. That's 13 years. It's literally three. You'll turn over 3 different high schools.
But that's what I'm saying. Yeah.
Fucking shit.
So
because it's working. It's working now. What we're doing. We're going to keep doing what we're doing now.
Yeah.
Right. So I slid that. They gave us like this priority thing, and we could like move things around as to like what's priority today versus what's long term stuff. And I kept moving it to like today. And then other people, you know, everyone in the group has access to it. And so some people kept bumping it. And so I waited until like the time was almost up, and I grabbed it and I slid it back to today, like really fast. So we have another meeting coming up, I think in a week or two. And I'm interested to see where it pops up on the timeline again for the next meeting.
You pulled an eBay move.
Yep. Wait until 3 seconds left on the auction.
Yep. Damn right. I mean, you know, these old people need to learn how to play the game. Oh, man. All right, so Johnny Bruce probably got some shit coming up. It's already 7:30. Fuck him. I'm done. I don't have any notes. It's been an hour and a half.
I want to go over my Chinese stuff here, this dystopian that is existing in our planet right now.
Do it. Right on. Anna, thanks for joining. That was awesome.
You want to
bone out there, and then Carl's going to... We're going to jump into some Chinese democracy nonsense.
Yeah. I'll catch you back on Facebook.
Right on.
Bye.
Thanks. Right. Thanks for talking.
No worries.
Bye.
I don't even know if Anna still does spilling the CCSD tea. I haven't seen it lately, but I mean, like, it's good to know. Like, I mean, you know, she's on the planning board. Who knew that shit? I was bitching about that last week.
No, this conversation was very stimulating. It was awesome.
I know,
this is
right?
The stuff, this is the stuff every candidate in the county needs to be talking about.
I know. Like
our
if you were
our schools are literally the most important.
Oh, if any school
of
board,
government, right?
Any school board trustee that doesn't follow Anna around and see what she's talking about is not doing their job. Because yeah, I mean, there's certain people that really give a shit.
And we didn't even hit on what happened at the so what school was it? That had some sort of, was it a shooting?
El Dorado. No, it wasn't a shooting. All right, so. As of the latest reading that I've gotten, and see, no one's going to get mad because I'm not going to fuck this up. The kid, kid came in with no personal beef with this teacher, said he wanted to talk about his grades, got behind the teacher, and decided, all of a sudden, the voices in his head told him to fuck up a teacher. He took a computer cord, he wrapped it around her throat, he choked her till she thought, he was dead. She pretended to be dead. He knocked over fucking filing cabinets and shit on top of her. Hacked at her fucking wrists with a pair of scissors. And said shit like, why won't you die? Called his fucking mother. And in some way molested her. I do not know the details of that. No need to discuss. But just, I mean, he attempted to kill her. Anything beyond that. So he eventually, said that he was going to, what the fuck was he going to do? He was going to, he was going to steal her keys and lock her in her fucking room. But, he heard somebody in the hallway and decided against that and just boogied.
How long did it take them to find her?
I don't know. I think it's because the tweet that I saw initially was that it happened to a custodian, but I think it was the custodian that found her. So it might have been at the end of the day, open office hours, and he came in under the ruse of looking at his grades, but he really just had bad intentions. He's a little mentally ill, according to him.
Wow.
Yeah, and he tried to murder a teacher. I cannot teach high school.
That's no.
I would need a separate entrance to the classroom. I would need a time.
You're not a kid in a cage.
I would need
bulletproof glass.
Yeah, I would need a time where I can enter that.
Teachers space. Are going to look like bank tellers.
Exactly.
Teachers are going to be like bank tellers.
Subway drivers. Subway drivers.
Separate entrances.
Yeah. Little
separate
microphone.
Entrances.
What's up? Sit down. Go sit down. Go sit down. Guys, go sit down. I'll have the whiteboard and all that shit. Go sit down. Just meet me for fucking 7.5 hours. Go sit down. Please sit down. I'll just be clicking up, putting shit up. You know what I mean? That'd be fucking high school.
Dude, you just predicted the future.
How can you not fucking do that, bro? You can't have kids fucking... I can't fight my way out of a fucking classroom. I'm a grown-ass man. I'm about to be 50-year-old dude. How the fuck do little ladies and little dudes fight their way through that shit? Eventually, you're going to have 2 or 3. You know, the one that was on top of that girl... punching her? There was no stopping her. Fuck that, dude.
What has happened, man?
You're going to have to teach from with. You're going to have a teacher pod where the teachers enter, go into the center of the building, and then go out in pods where students can see them.
What is this?
But can't touch
them. What is this a symptom of? What got us here? Honestly, what the fuck got us here? Our teachers are going to have to...
It's cyclical. Remember the 70s? Remember all them shitty movies when there'd be some principal, Stand By Me, you know, and he'd chain the door shut and kick all the drug dealers out? We're on the fucking... There's another end to that, to that thing.
Other side of that cycle?
It's coming into it. We're not going into the end of it. It's what the fuck happened where all of a sudden all the subway cars are covered in fucking... You know, 3 kids got stabbed yesterday. That kind of shit. It's the Bronx. You know what I mean? Like, it's just cyclical. It's just bleep. And then we're going to have all these crazy motherfuckers like us that are going to be like, I'll just carry a 2x4 and I'll fuck kids up if they do this shit. And
listen,
then it'll get better.
Listen.
Rudy Giuliani's.
Some FBI statistics up like multiple, and forget the proper term is, but when one person has violence against multiple people, like it's not like domestic violence. It's like if you were to go out and just beat up a couple people.
Yeah.
Like those incidences are on like some sort of multi-100% increase in America right now.
There's a lot of people I'm reading about that cause violence and then have a record of doing it already. Yeah, yeah. Like they're just randomly punching people. But they're people that have already been
increased right now.
Yeah, it seems
like. So it's
like
we're at each other's throat. Oh. Like there's literally something in our country putting us at each other's throat.
Huh. All right. What do you got about China?
It's happening. And this may be part of it.
Maybe it's a weapon they're using against us?
I don't know.
Chinese bioweapon that makes us fucking hate each other? Stop hating.
Yeah. All right. So this is, I'm learning technology here. I did share sound. What do we got?
Yeah, Anna said CCEA said that he came to her with intent to hurt her, no other reason. Yeah, it was under the guise that, you know, she had office hours, but.
So I don't know if we make this a bit or something, but I want to go through like my saved Instagram.
Meme review. Like, you're damn right. Here, watch
like
this.
A meme review?
Yeah, watch this. I'll actually, if I want to cut it later, here, I'll do
You got a cover?
I'll throw something to cut to. Hold on, still do a little standby. So we throw that in there, and then we throw in our breaking. Get some booze flowing.
People laughing. chat.
There's a meme review.
And then we'll go left display. Booze flowing. I wonder if I can make that bigger, or can you make it bigger?
Where?
Oh, you could just click on the post.
What can you see? Can you see my phone right now?
I can see I can see a bunch of 15 little squares of your posts, all your posts. Yeah.
This is the past 15 saves.
All right.
From Instagram. And mind you, my only source of news is Instagram.
Memes flowing, people laughing.
Fun. I've just now recently opened Twitter back up with Elon stuff going on. That's going to be a new battlefield for me.
I never did fuck with the live thing. Yeah, it didn't work out.
What? You didn't with the, is that what they call it, live?
Or whatever.
Because it used to be Periscope, right? Periscope's the video. This is the audio rooms.
Yeah, this is audio.
Yeah.
Fuck it.
I haven't played with that yet.
Yeah, it'll stay on there for a little while. We'll see how it goes.
Let's watch a couple of videos. I think I turned the sound on. Let me know if you can hear it.
All right. Yeah, I hear it.
All right.
Jesus Christ.
All right. So that's in it. That's someone in a Shanghai quarantine zone. So that they've been positively ID'd with some sort of bullshit test that they have COVID or some variant or, and they're pulled out of their house, which they were locked in for the past 16, 17 days now. The Chinese have locked up 26 million people in their homes.
Ooh. Turn your phone sideways.
In one of their largest cities over a new wave of COVID that has come upon the nation. There's some weird things I'm seeing as well.
What happens if you turn your phone sideways? Yeah. Will it work better?
So this is a guy who's locked in his condo, in his home. He's trying to not get yanked out and taken to one of those places where that lady was just screaming.
Oh, is he about to jump? Oh, are they shooting fucking pepper sprays at him? Yeah, they fucking... Yeah, they just like gang up on him with a shield. Bro, you should have just jumped.
Some people have.
Yeah. Wow.
All because he's got a cold.
Yeah.
He's got a little cold. We got a.
Dude, what if he took a couple of these dudes with him? That'd be sick.
All right. You get the point.
Right. Yeah.
And then there's stuff like this
I
watch.
If you're down today, you can have a little bit of my sunshine. Hey, if you're down.
It's I go between things like that and things like this all day.
Right.
So, like, my emotional stability, like, These things are very manipulative.
Oh my God.
And, I mean, they're, but there's something here. Where's this one? I had one more. Oh, this is a funny one. Babylon B is the best. He's the best. Let's see. Where is that other one? This shit. We don't need the screaming. Now, remember when the COVID one hit? You know, damn. the first.
Yeah, they just grab a fool.
When we had those videos come out of China where the people were just like falling down, you know, just dropping as they're walking. I'm very reluctant to believe any video coming out of China. Like, first of all, don't they have the Great Wall, Internet Wall of China, where nothing, you know, comes and goes that they don't want?
Yeah.
Like, but they want the world to see what they're doing to their citizens right now.
Yeah.
Why on earth? All right. Now, I got something here. Where is the one? I think it's...
What children are going through right now in Shanghai?
Is it this one? Oh, this one. 跑吃冷静跟你说这不是我们警察造成的这个是整个国际形势造成的 International situation. If you continue to behave like this, we are going to war with America, don't you know?
Oh, wow.
This is the only one hope. The Communist Party can save China now.
Yeah. He said there's no hope.
Their citizens, and again, this could be complete bullshit because I don't know whatever Mandarin.
Well... Right? You would hear people in the U.S. say the same thing. Hey, man, you need to get in line. Now, damn it, we're at war with China. Right?
Yeah, they're telling if that's proper, like, they're telling us it's because of COVID, you know, or there's a lockdown because of COVID. But the people they're dragging away, they're talking about a coming war with America.
Mm-mm.
Because they don't want war with America, so they're grabbing their dissidents out of Shanghai, their largest city. They're grabbing their dissidents, just like there's dissidents in the United States that don't want to go to war with Ukraine.
Yeah.
We're not getting yanked of our houses. They locked down their largest city. I think it's their largest, Shanghai. Beijing might be more. Yeah. 26 million people.
It's fucking huge.
They're locking them down so they can come grab any dissident who doesn't want to go to war with America.
Well, they're already at war with America, and that's what he said.
That's what's happening in Shanghai right now.
Yeah, that's what he said.
They're pulling the dissidents under guise of lockdown.
Right.
For COVID.
That makes sense. I mean, never let a good crisis go to waste, right? Saul Alinsky said it. So, yeah, I would say, while you got it locked down, you might as well run these fuckers through a filter, right? Pull out the bad seeds. What do you got? What children are going through right
now? And then you got this.
Yeah, what is this? That's a kid.
Yeah, got a positive ID for COVID. Separated from his family, taken to that little camp where the lady was losing her mind.
Bye, Mom. Bye, Dad. Wow.
I can't. It's
That's awesome.
This is said, maybe I'm an NPC. No, having the same opinions as celebrities and major corporations while repeating every media talking point verbatim is what real people do.
I check in all the time to see if I'm an NPC. It's possible.
Yeah, try to. Maybe an anti-NPC. I don't know. Maybe that's a program as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, but yeah, it's... what's going on in China is serious shit.
Oh, man. And there's a million cities in China that are bigger than any of our cities. It's insane how many Chinese people are.
Are you up to date on Australia? Australia?
No. I don't fuck with Australia.
It's back to a prison colony.
It was a prison colony, yeah. I'm annoyed with how they say, I know. They say, I know. And I'm tired of it. So fuck them.
Fuck them.
Because they don't know how to say the word no. Noi.
Annoy.
I don't know. Like, I don't know. What the fuck? It's annoying.
Yeah.
So They're locked down. Yeah, they're famous for that shit. Every mayor, every state. Go ahead. Yeah.
What on earth is going on? We got countries locking down over this COVID shit.
Yeah.
We got China playing like they're locking down over COVID shit to kill dissidents. The Ukraine stuff, you know, with the biolabs, whatever. We don't even get any straight information. The whole world is on just like on the brink of explosion, right? Like, what happens next? Like, what happens next?
You got a little chatter about
some new variant coming in the U.S. right now, talking about we're going to do lockdowns here again, right? Because we didn't lock down good enough last time. Now no one leaves their house, right? We got to do a real lockdown this time because this one, you know, this one's going to get you.
Yeah, I don't know if anybody's going to fall for that shit anymore.
I don't know, man. I don't know. There's still people wearing masks.
I know. It's kind of weird. A lot of people still wearing chin diapers. I'm like, you got the option to take it off. Why are you wearing it wrong?
And you, what the?
Yeah. That's bizarre. Like, you don't want to wear it, so you pull it around your chin. Just take it the fuck off.
Listen, half our population will go for it and fight the other population that won't go for it. That's the only answer the elite got for us.
Yeah.
We got all these weapons. They want us to fight each other. And you can see, but with everything that's happening, every division, you know, race, color, creed, gender, whatever, we're divided. And they want us to fight each other. They just got to find something to metastasize it, right? And COVID didn't work the first time. It didn't work. We're too lazy.
Yeah.
Too lazy to fight each other. Oh, we're too lazy. But if we're hungry and we're less lazy. So
that's true.
See what happens.
Then we'll really get
after
it.
See what happens in the next few months.
Oh boy, fun. All right, I'm gonna end it on that positive note, man. Hey, 100 episodes. That's fucking cool, give or take, whatever. It's all good.
I forgot to put my conspiracy glasses on. Right? I was supposed to put these on.
Let me see. What is good? Oh, yeah. Let's just get back to I'll hit the roasting and then get the fuck out of here. Thanks for watching. 100 episodes and all that shit. Sharelle was here.
That was a pretty
Anna Binder was here. Yeah, that was pretty fucking dope.
That was a great conversation.
Yeah, yeah. I wish we could be like this more often. And, maybe. As the campaign is heating up, people are going to be looking for outlets to, you know, really get after it. So I think now that people...
Maybe have a little fun when you're so stressed out all the time.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And sorry for Sharelle's loss, and I appreciate her showing up, and that's cool. Yeah, people come let your hair down a little bit. You don't even have to turn on your camera. It helps if you do, but you don't have to. All right, we're out of here.
I just roasted the roaster, and so I still roast. I'm just that way. I'm that guy. I roast probably every other week.
Roasty roast.
And I roast up.
I roast it.
Pretty significant amount.
Pretty significant. I love Sherman.
Yeah.
Gives me something to watch. Good. Oh, yeah, actually, I had the day off the other day and I was actually commenting and there was a dog barking.
They can hear us talking, right?
Yeah, a little bit in the background. Under the music. But he had a dog barking and he acknowledged my comment because I was like, oh, you got a fucking dog barking in the studio next door. But.
Yeah, sweet. People watch this show.
What, this?
Yeah.
I guess.
I can't believe people watch this show.
Seagal Shita has no idea who the fuck we are. But Sharelle does.
Well, she'll find it out. She'll
find
out.
The Christian Warrior candidates know, because I goofed on them. They're like, what?
Listen, I'm also the Christian Warrior candidates.
I love them. All right, let me end this thing.
All right.
The fucking shit. It stops. Boom.